This is the 4-post rack mount installation tutorial for online high density UPS series. This installation tutorial applies to all 4U models of online high density UPS series and their compatible extended battery modules. Important notice: before installation, please read the safety precautions that can be found in the user's manual, quick start guide, and or other related documents. To start, prepare the following items, which come with the UPS unit. The EBM kit is used for EBM installation only, which contains the following items. In addition, you will also need to prepare other accessories and tools before the installation. Remove the 5 dust covers from the screw holes on both sides of the UPS. Install the 2 rack mount ears onto both sides of the UPS using 4 black flathead screws on each side. Then, install the 2 hanging brackets onto both sides of the UPS using 3 silver pan head screws on each side. Place the rack mount rail, marked with R, to the right side of the server rack using the round head screw for positioning and easy installation. Secure the rack mount rail to the server rack using 4 black pan head screws and 4 plastic washers. Follow the same procedures to secure the rack mount rail, marked with L, onto the left side of the server rack. Slide the hanging brackets on the UPS onto the rack mount rails on the server rack. A locking mechanism is used on the hanging rails to ensure safety. To slide the UPS out from the server rack, press the locking tabs to release the UPS. Secure the UPS to the server rack by using 2 black pan head screws on each side. Proceed to connect the input terminal block power cord to the UPS and to the utility grid. First, take the input-output terminal block cover and loosen the 2 screws to detach the top cover. Then, assemble the cable gland onto the bottom cover by tightening the lock nut and the cable gland body with the sealing nut. Fix the bottom cover with the cable gland to the input terminal block of the UPS by tightening the 2 screws. Insert the input terminal block power cord through the cable gland and connect the brown, green, yellow striped, and blue wires to the line, ground, and neutral terminals respectively. Tighten the screws to fix the wires using the slotted screwdriver, and tighten the sealing nuts to secure the power cord. Replace the top cover by using the 2 screws. Then, connect the terminal block power cord to the utility grid. The LCD of the UPS will turn on and show standby mode. To complete the installation, press and hold the power button for 3 seconds to turn on the UPS. The UPS will run a self-test and operate in battery mode first, which may take a few seconds. Then transfer to line mode and is ready for use. To use the extended battery modules for longer power backup, follow the same rack mount installation procedures. Before connecting the extended battery module to the UPS, make sure the DC breaker is off. Remove the battery cable retention bracket of the UPS and the extended battery module by loosening the 4 screws. Connect the output cable of the extended battery module to the UPS. Rotate and replace the battery cable retention bracket by tightening the 4 screws to secure the battery cable from loosening. If more than one extended battery module is required, repeat the same procedures to connect them with one another. Use the power cord for EBM connection to connect the AC outlet of the first extended battery module to the AC inlet of the next one. Repeat this procedure to connect all extended battery modules. Plug the power cord for utility connection to the AC inlet of the first extended battery module into the utility grid. For extended battery module management, connect the BM cable to the BM port of the UPS and to the BM port marked with IN of the first extended battery module. Then, use another BM cable to connect the BM port marked with OUT of the first extended battery module to the BM port marked with IN of the next one. Repeat this procedure to connect all extended battery modules. Next, use the BMP cable to connect the BMP port of the UPS to the BMP port on the left side of the first extended battery module. Tighten the four black round head screws to secure the BMP cable from loosening. Then, use another BMP cable to connect the BMP port on the right side of the first extended battery module to the BMP port on the left side of the next one, followed by tightening the screws. Repeat this procedure to connect all extended battery modules. Turn on the DC breakers of all the extended battery modules. Finally, to make sure the EBMs are properly installed, you may check the number of connected EBMs via the LCD panel. Press the Enter button to access the main menu. Select the UPS status and scroll to the external battery. When you see the number of installed EBMs is correctly displayed, the UPS and EBMs are ready for use.